What's up, Rose Show Tactical subscribers and viewers? In today's video, I'm going to be giving you a breakdown and opinion of a holster I just picked up for the Glock 43X. As you can tell by the title of the video, it is the DeSantis Pegasus. I did have one of these holsters when they originally came out. It was called the Slim Tuck. And I bought it for the Beretta APX Carry because it was one of the only holsters that were out at the time that I was interested in. I didn't want something that was a hybrid holster with, you know, leather or some kind of synthetic with like a, you know, a plastic or a Kydex shell on it. I didn't want anything like that. I don't own anything like that. So I got that. I wasn't a huge fan of a couple things about that holster, and I'll kind of show you with this holster what's different and what I like about this a little more. Right here, on the original holster, this wasn't cut up as much. It was more like down here. So it dug a little bit into my groin area when I'm carrying in the appendix position. And the major issue I have with it is you can see here where it has the hardware and the screw attachment here where you can put on whatever you want. This is flat, right? It comes across here and it's flat and then goes up. The one on the APX Carry like dipped down. So it was like down here. So it would go here and then dip down. And again, it just, it dug into my groin, and I wasn't a huge fan of, you know, how it felt when I had the actual gun in the holster. So, you know, I got rid of that to somebody that I know that has an APX Carry. Much like everybody else, when I purchase a gun, I'm always looking for holster options because I'm gonna carry the gun. And what I'm looking for is I'm looking for something that's really, you know, fits my carry style, fits my lifestyle. And that's, you know, something that's very thin, very slim, very minimalistic. It is always kind of what I'm looking for. And I do like, as I stated in multiple videos, even though I don't run optics on my pistols because I'm not a huge fan of having just a bunch of crap on my gun. Being a minimalist, I don't like having threaded barrels and red dots and lasers and mag extensions and all this extra crap on my gun that I don't need. But I do like having optics cuts on the holster just because, you know, it can help you get it out of there a little bit easier. If you're going to pull this gun out of the holster, instead of going all the way up and coming out like this, once you clear that, you can get it out and start the process a little bit faster. This gun has been safety checked, and all the, internet, you know, gun police out there. But that's why I like having a cutout on the holster. It goes in and out a little bit easier, a little bit faster. So I'm a fan of that. This one here, I feel is updated from the original version of the Pegasus Slim Tuck, whatever you want to call it, when it came out. I think it looks pretty cool. These lines in here, obviously there's, you know, slide serrations on the front and the back of the slide on the Glock 43X. These are more at an angle. So is there really a function for the gun in the holster with these? Not really. That's more for aesthetics, but I think it adds to the look and I think it looks pretty cool. It's very, very lightweight, very thin. As you can see, the fit and the finish on it is really, really nice. Everything fits the way that it should. Obviously the trigger guard there. It's just really nice. And what I like about it is the fact that, again, it's very slim. It's very thin. It's very, very minimalistic. And that's what I'm looking for when I'm personally carrying something. So I'll put the gun in here. You can hear it's got a nice positive snap right there. You can hear that. That's what it looks like with the gun in there. It looks really nice. It fits really nice in there. I'm a fan of DeSantis anyway. I carry their mag packer in my pocket every single day because I don't like a bunch of stuff on my belt. You know, extra mag carriers and stuff like that. I have it, you know, in my pocket. I carry my knife and I carry my gun. So I'm already a fan of the products from DeSantis. So, you know, very happy, with this product. I got this at Cabela's. Cabela's, you know, had different Blackhawks and, you know, all Galcos and all kinds of different stuff. But again, I'm either a Kydex or like a thermal molded or injected plastic or a polymer. I just think that that's best for carrying a gun, for making sure that the gun stays in the holster, and that the trigger guard is always protected and there's no chance of it, you know, folding or anything like that, like sometimes can happen with hybrid or soft holsters like leather. So I'm a big fan of that. As you can see here in the trigger guard, I mean, it's locked up there. It's extremely, and you can, and I mean, you can see when we get this here, I mean, it barely adds any bulk at all to the gun. I mean, it's very, very slim, very, very lightweight. And I really, really like it. You know, I originally planned on getting this so I could get the gun in the waistband and then maybe looking at some other things. And now after getting this, I'm not so sure that I'm going to do that. There is a holster that I'm looking at for a couple of my guns that is a brand new holster on the market from a company that does training and whatnot. I don't want to give it away until I actually have it, but they have been completely sold out on their website. They've been completely sold out of this holster at manufacturers that actually carry their holster. So I've had a really hard time getting it. So I hope to be able to get one of those as soon as possible, kind of try it out, test it out, and then review that. But this thing is awesome. I mean, there's really no negative that I can see from this holster. Like, I always try and look for, okay, well, what do I like about it? What do I dislike about it? What's good? What's bad? You know, what kind of things, you know, can I share from my experience and try and help people make, you know, certain decisions that they may be looking at something. But I mean, this was, I believe, $35 or $40 the holster was. And then I have multiple claws and extra parts and whatnot, you know, on my workbench, so I didn't have to pay for this, but I did buy this DCC. This is a Mod 4 clip here. The reason I got this is when you buy a holster, you can't always guarantee that the holster manufacturer is going to drill holes and whatnot that are going to match hardware that you want to add as an aftermarket part on your holster. You know, so I bought this because it has just slots. It has a slot here and a slot here, so you can adjust it, right? You can adjust where you want to mount it, whereas some of the other ones just have specific holes drilled into them, and if it's off, then it won't fit. So I got this Mod 4. It's the same, you know, spring kind of very sturdy clip there that has the claw on the back of the clip that's on the monoblock clips, which I'm a huge fan of. I don't really like loops on my holsters. I don't like I'm just not a fan of having loops on my holsters, but I'm also not a huge fan of having just like plastic clips on my holsters. So I usually go with, you know, something from Discreet Carry Concepts, either the Mod 4 or the Monoblock, or I usually go with like an Ulti clip. Those are the only two things that I really run on my holsters, just because I want to guarantee that it's going to, you know, not come off when I draw the holster. I haven't had any problems with Ulti clip or any projects or any products from DCC ever on any holster that I've ever had. So, you know, I do trust them. I've, you know, drawn my pistol hundreds and hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of times with each of them and never had it come off of my belt. So, that's obviously a plus. I did add, that there and add the claw on this. It just comes, you know, standard with the holster and their kind of plastic clip. I like this because the grip on the 43X is just a little bit bigger than, you know, what is on the Hellcat or what is on, you know, the 365 with the mag. You know, it comes out to here, right? So it's a little bit, it sticks out a little bit farther, it prints a little bit more. But with this, you know, it kind of pulls it back to my body a little bit more, which helps me conceal it better. And so that's why I added this. So far, carrying this in my belt for the last couple of weeks, it's been very, very comfortable. Easy to draw from, you know, easy to get the gun back in the holster. And I just been, you know, thoroughly impressed with this product. I mean, it's not very expensive, $35-$40. You may be even able to find it on eBay or Amazon, something like that, even cheaper. Like I said, I was just looking to get this so I could, you know, have something and get the gun in the holster. And I have just been, you know, very, very impressed with the fit, the function, how slim it is, how comfortable it is, the fact that, you know, I can get the clip and the claw on there and do what I want to it, you know, make it, you know, personalized for my carry style. And again, I can't say really anything negative about this holster. If you were to ask me, like, well, what would be some reasons why I wouldn't want this, or, you know, what are some things you don't like about it? I don't have anything. It's just, it's a really, really great holster for the money. The fit, the function, I think it also looks really nice, which, you know, again, people are going to be like, well, that doesn't matter. Sure it does. And there's nobody out there that buys a gun that you know, tricks the gun out or buys a holster and or whatever that isn't thinking at some point about whether it looks nice and they like the way that it looks. That's total BS. If that wasn't the case, then we wouldn't have 784 different colors, designs of Kydex for you to wear inside your waistband, right? Because if you have a holster in your waistband, you know, the only time you're seeing that is when you're putting the gun in the holster and putting it in your waistband. Nobody sees it. So what does it matter how tricked out your holster is, right? So to say that things like, you know, is it aesthetically pleasing to me? Does it look nice? You know, if you disagree with that, you're lying, you know, you're lying to me, you're lying to yourself. So that's it for me. Again, I think this is a really great option. I know they make this holster for tons of different guns that are out there. This one to me is a much better, like I said, updated version of what originally was the case when I bought it a couple years ago. So that's it for me. I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope I covered everything about this holster that may be important. If I didn't, and there's something that you want to know or you want me to dive deeper into, leave it in the comment section below. I'll be happy to let you know or give you my opinion on that. Subscribe to the channel. Hit the little bell icon so you know when I release new content. And until next time, I'm out of here.